how would you go about exchanging serial Modbus data with Allen Bradley PLC data? Well, one way might be to use the Groove Edge appliance and embedded software like Ignition Edge and Node-RED. As an example, we have this Whatnode energy metering device accumulating energy data from this workshop. From this Groove Edge appliance here, we are going to read the accumulated energy from a Modbus register on the Whatnode over the serial connection using Node-RED, and then write to a different register to reset the accumulated value with this push button, which is wired to the Allen Bradley PLC. We'll do the PLC portion with Ignition Edge and its built-in OPC UA server. These devices are typical examples of what you might find on the edge of an industrial automation system, where normally the AB PLC and serial devices cannot easily communicate, but the industrially hardened Groovebox bridges the gap between devices without requiring a PC on site. To learn more about setting up Node-RED or Ignition Edge on the Groove Edge appliance, check out our other videos on workshops.opto22.com. In this video, we will focus on gathering Modbus data and reading an input from the Allen Bradley PLC, and we'll cover a lot of things like how to get serial Modbus data in and out of the Groovebox with Node-RED, how to get a push button state from an Allen Bradley PLC into the Groovebox with Ignition Edge, how to set up Ignition Edge for Node-RED integration, how to create and view Ignition tags using the Designer app, and finally, how to configure the Ignition Node-RED read and write nodes to exchange data. Let's get started. First, we'll take a look at the net energy usage being measured by the serial Whatnode device. The best place to do this is to see where it's brought into Node-RED. I'll navigate there now by opening a browser and heading to https://, the hostname or IP address of your Groovebox, :1880. Acknowledge the security warnings and proceed to your Node-RED instance, where you can log in with your Groove admin credentials. Here, I already have a flow set up. This node simply reads the workshop's accumulated energy from the Modbus register, in this case, reading from register 1000 every 2 seconds. Then the value is extracted, formatted, and printed to the debug pane on the right. If I go to the debug pane and enable this node, I can see the accumulated energy showing up on the right-hand side here. We are going to write this net energy measurement value to an ignition tag for future reference, as well as read a button value from the Allen Bradley PLC through the Ignition OPC UA server. This will use the Ignition read and write nodes. Once the button value is in Node-RED, it will trigger a reset of the measurement inside the Whatnode device so it starts accumulating again from zero. This is done by writing to the reset register using this node here, set for register 1619. Resetting the total could be useful for finding out how much energy is being used in a given day, during a shift, or over a certain production cycle. There are two things we need to do to link Node-RED and Ignition Edge. That is to install the Ignition node package and the Node-RED module. To install the nodes, open the menu and select Manage Palette. From here, go to the Install tab and search Ignition. Go ahead and install the top result. Now, before we can move on to Ignition Edge, we will need to make sure that it's running, that we have access, and also find and download the module file. To manage Ignition Edge, we need to open Groove Admin in a new tab by going to https://, the same hostname or IP address, and this time at port 10,000. Again, you'll need to log in with your Groove Admin credentials, and then select the Ignition Edge tab on the left-hand side. If you don't see this, you'll need to update your Groovebox to the latest admin update. From here, ensure that the boxes to enable and run Ignition Edge at startup and the checkbox to enable access to Ignition Edge Designer and Edge Panel are both ticked, and hit Save. Next, we will need to download the Node-RED module file, which can be found by visiting a great Node-RED resource, flows.nodered.org. From here, we can search for the Ignition node package and see its requirements, specifically the Ignition module. Follow this GitHub link and go ahead and download the file. Now we're ready to head over to Ignition Edge. This will be at port 8043. If this is your first time using this instance of Ignition Edge, there are some initial setup items you will want to do, including changing the default admin password login credentials. If you are unsure how to do this, please check out our previous workshop video that goes over this process. Once you're signed in, go to the main Configure tab, and under the first System category, select Modules. This will take you to the main module configuration page. At the bottom, there is an option to install or upgrade a module. Select that, and provide the file you just downloaded. Click Install, and approve the self-signed certificate to give Node-RED permission to access the Ignition Tag database. Once that process is successfully completed, there will be a new category, Node-RED, with the single sub-item API tokens. Select that, and create a new Node-RED API token and secret. This pair is the key password set that authorizes Node-RED to access the tag database. The name can be anything, so I'll call this set Workshop. And the API token, Opto22, Opto22, Opto, since it must be exactly 16 characters, no more and no less. Set a password, make sure that the key stays enabled, and create the token. Before we go back to Node-RED, let's check out the Ignition Tag database to see what we can read from and write to. Since we already enabled Edge Designer in Groove Admin, we are free to launch it using this button in the top right and open the file. Note that once you have this file, you can feel free to go back and untick that box in Groove Admin to close the insecure TCP port. Also note that you will need Java to run this app, so if you don't already have it, follow the prompts to the free download before you continue. Once the designer is open, we can log in with Ignition Edge credentials and see the entire tag structure in the tag browser window. By default, there will be two main folders under tags, data types and edge nodes. You'll have to make the subfolder structure for your devices under edge nodes, but I have some here already. At the top, we can see the Group ID folder, usually named for the device or vendor that the tags originate from, so I've used the vendor name Opto22. Under that, we can see the Edge Node ID folder, usually named for the location, so for me, that's Opto Workshop. Under that is the specific device ID, which I've named Groove Edgebox. I already have one subfolder associated with this device for the Allen Bradley PLC. If I expand that, I can see some of the tags that are available. If I hit the toggle button now, we can see it changes to true and back to false when I release. This happens through the Ignition Edge OPC UA server that connects the Allen Bradley PLC with the Groovebox. The names of these tags and folders don't matter too much, but the folder structure of Group ID, Edge Node ID, and Device ID is important, so be sure to follow this convention when creating a new folder structure. To easily find this value again, right-click it and copy the tag path to your clipboard. To give us an endpoint in the tag database to write to, I will create a new subfolder called Groove Edge. To create this folder, I right-click on the device ID and select New Folder. Here I can give it the name Groove Edge. To create a new tag under this device ID folder, right-click on the folder and hover over New Tag. Right now, don't worry about the other tag types, just select Memory Tag. For this example, I'll call it Net Energy and set the data type to be Float. Here, we can see it's shown up in the tag structure. So now we have all the tags we need for Node-RED. Go back to that first tab, and since the Ignition nodes are already installed, we can scroll to the bottom and drag in an Ignition tag read node and double-click it to edit its settings. Here, you'll want to select the pencil icon to add a new Ignition server and give it all the required details. Here I provide the API token and keyset that I made in Ignition Edge. For me, that's Opto22, Opto22, Opto, and the password. Make sure to enter these exactly because they're both case sensitive. You can leave the default tag provider, and since this configuration will work for both reading and writing, you can just go ahead and save it, and then paste the tag path from your clipboard that you copied a moment ago. Next, let's test the connection between the AB PLC and the Groovebox. This is as simple as dragging in an inject and debug node. Wire these two together, deploy the flow, and when I inject, I can see that the energy reset boolean is in the payload under ignition result held and value. Right now the value is false, but if I hit the reset button connected to the Allen Bradley PLC and inject again, I will see a new value of true. So we know the connection is working. Before I do anything more with this data, I need to see the format that is required by the Modbus node. If I select the Modbus node and look at the info tab, I can see that it's required to be on message.payload, whereas the ignition tag was in message.payload.ignitionResult.value. To make this change, I can simply use a change node. I will use this to move message.payload.ignitionResult.value into just message.payload. Also, since this value is being put into a register, it must be changed from a true-false boolean to the number 1 or 0. Again, the change node is perfect for this. I'll drag in another one. I will use it to change the message.payload property and search for the value true and replace it with the value 1. And add another rule to search message.payload for the boolean value false and replace that with 0. Lastly, I'll change the input node to regularly inject every 2 seconds, as well as adding a rate by exception node to make sure it doesn't update the value every second that it is checked. The default to block unless value changes is perfect for this. Now I can wire these nodes together. I can deploy and enable the debug output of the current net energy. That value is now appearing in the debug pane every 2 seconds. Once I've wired the flow together, I can deploy, enable the debug output of the current net energy, so that when I hit the button to toggle the energy reset variable on the Allen Bradley PLC, I can see that Node Red has taken the change in the ignition tag and put 1 into Modbus register 1619. So we have a flow of data from the Allen Bradley PLC to the serial WhatNode device. And now we're counting back up from 0. Finally, as well as using the ignition read node, I'll also use an ignition write node to put the accumulated energy value into the net energy tag that we created in Ignition Edge Designer earlier. Before we can feed this data into the ignition write node, it needs to be carefully repackaged, just like the serial node required. To see what the write node needs, again, check out the info tab. In this case, the value to write must be on message.payload.tagValue. Another thing to keep in mind is that as well as being on the correct path, the input must be of the same data type as the tag in the ignition tag database. Here, they're both decimal, so we're good to go there. To get the message.payload to a message.payload.tagValue, I could use another change node to move like I did above, but instead, I'll use a function node to show you how to make this change with JavaScript. First, I'm going to create a new object to return. It is going to have the single property tag value, which I will assign the value of the current message.payload. Then I simply return a new message object where the payload is the new object I just built. Simple as that. Now the value is ready to write. To make finding this tag path easier, I can once again go to Edge Designer, right-click on Net Energy, and copy the tag path to my clipboard so that it's easy to paste into Node-RED. Once I provide the node with the server that I set up earlier, I can hit Done, Deploy, and now every 2 seconds, this Modbus node will fetch the energy data. This function node handles the buffer to float conversion, takes that number and moves it to the correct message path, and finally writes it to the float net energy in the ignition tag database. If we head back over to the ignition designer, we can see that the tag is updating live already. And right now, we've used just a few kilowatt hours. How cool is that? So there you have it. We have shown you how to install, configure, and use the Ignition Node-RED module to read and write Ignition OPC way tags without using a PC, just this industrially hardened IoT appliance. Combining the power of Node-RED and Ignition Edge on the Groovebox gives you a whole range of ways to move different types of data to suit your needs. With this energy data now in Node-RED, I am free to write it to a database like SQL, displayed in Groove, even send it to be analyzed by artificial intelligence software like IBM's Watson or anything else you can imagine. To learn more, check out our other videos on workshops.opto22.com. Thanks for watching.